already, then what is going on, everybody? It's your boy Sunny here coming at you guys with another Neverwinter video. And by the title and thumbnail, obviously you know why you clicked on, but just to reiterate, we are going to be discussing the Wasteland lockbox, kind of giving you guys an in-depth review, breakdown, and my thoughts and opinions on it, and should you open it, right? This lockbox includes the Hellfire Steed in terms of its... Let's just jump into the mount itself, because that's what everybody's trying to pull. Unfortunately, it's just cosmetically appealing to me. Maybe some of you out there also might want it. Any mount collectors out there, I feel like, as a whole, this is one of the better mounts that they could have put out. But in terms of equip power and combat power, obviously they're shit. There's no other way around it. Neverwinter, in the next lockbox, please give us... You know, I don't know if they're waiting for the mythic mounts, because you know they're coming. It's just a matter of time. Neverwinter put account-wide legendary mounts in the Zen market. Let that just sink in for a minute, guys. You get, like, people maybe who just started recently playing or have been playing, even in the past couple year, 2 years, if you haven't been playing since the beginning, you know Cryptic doesn't do nothing for no reason, right? Them putting legendary mounts that are account-wide is just... You know, of course it benefits us, right? But to a lot of us, we know it's coming. You know it's coming. If they're going to be obsolete, then they're going to be obsolete. It's just a matter of time. It's just going to be like getting a rare mount. I'm telling you, once these mythic mounts come out, it's just going to be a wrap in terms of legendaries. I mean, even if you go to legendaries right now, I know we're getting a little sidetracked. But, you know, it's just pathetic. I mean, come on, 3 million, 4 million. You know, these were just... up from 6-7 million, and these go on every tune you'll ever make, so the value in itself is going to be worth it in its own. You used to pay 6-9 million for one legendary. Now you're getting it for 3-4 million, and you get it for every tune. Times are changing, times are changing. But in terms of the mount, like I said, it's just cosmetically appealing. Other than that, let's just go break down the rest of the items in here. Wasteland Epic Mount Pack. We have the Carpet and Grip It Epic Variations, and they actually put the Heavy Inferno Nightmare as the Epic Variation to the Hellfire Steed. I think they could have added an Epic Variation, in my own opinion, because the Hellfire Steed does not look... not the Hellfire Steed. The Heavy Inferno looks nothing like the Hellfire Steed. But, you know, it is what it is. It's right here. Inferno Night... No. Heavy... Inferno? What is that? What it was? Or is that? What was the name? Jeez Louise, my memory is that shot. Heavy Inferno. Okay, so yeah, it was that fire-looking horse. I don't think I like this one actually way better. Obviously, it is legendary, but even as an epic variation, I think they could have slimmed it down a little bit. You know, maybe took off some of its armor and just gave us kind of that lava feel, right? Because I think that's what it's more going for. Would have been nice. The Epic Companion Pack, we're just going to skim through it. It's pretty shit. These companions on here ain't BIS. I don't see too many people running these. Book Imp, a Quesset, and an Iron Golem. I don't even know what that Q1 is, if I'm even probably saying it right. Who knows? Moving on, Epic Insignias. Not a bad thing in here, of course. Rank 9 and 10. This is something interesting, right? They're putting both rank 9 and 10s in this lockbox. I believe this is the first time they've actually done this, where they put both rank 9s and 10s. So, you know, the prices of rank 9s and 10s are going to go down even more, which in return drops the value of anything further than that. Just due to the fact is, if people are buying rank 10s at a cheaper price, that means they can rank... That means they can make any rank higher than that at a cheaper price. So, you know, it's just going to drop the market down a little bit. Jadeites. Refinement, Trade Bar Jackpot, and then the regular basic shit that comes in here, right? Nothing too crazy. The only thing that's really missing from this box, to just put it, in my opinion, on the extra up, is cubes, right? And maybe putting out the Jadeites and putting them down here, or taking out something down here, I guess, maybe, and putting the cubes in here would just make it that much better, because in my opinion, I'm more of a cube guy, because you always need cubes. And cubes, there's only one place you can get them from, and that's lockboxes. And there's nothing else you can do about that. So that one is a little bit more hard to acquire. But other than that, I can't, I, you know, I don't find too many faults with this lockbox. It's not a bad one when you're looking at it to open it. You're not going to be pulling from, let's just compare it to the previous. You're not going to be pulling any shitty artifacts that are obsolete. You're not going to be pulling this, you know, Genie's Gifts. You know, not to say that Genie's Gifts, you don't necessarily need them anymore. You know, cubes are in this one. This one only has rank 8s, whereas the other one has rank 9 and 10s. So, I mean, not a bad come up from the previous one. Not bad at all. Like I said, should you open this? Why not, right? If you're a VIP member, or even if you're looking to indulge yourself in maybe some keys, I would open this one. I'd give it a try. Let me know down in the comments if you want me to get my luck at it and give it a couple swigs. You know, maybe with our combined efforts, right? Like Captain Planet, we'll be able to acquire this Hellfire Steed. But other than that, I mean, that's going to be it for this video. I don't like to make my videos too long. I just like to get short, sweet, and to the point. Should you open it? I believe so. Is there better lockboxes out there? I would think. Just because of due to the fact is the legendary mounts in here aren't that sought after. Unfortunately, the only thing going for this legendary mount is cosmetics. But to me, cosmetics is big in Neverwinter. People spend millions on cosmetics, so putting one in a legendary mount and pulling it is still not a bad one. You know, if you pull epic, you know, probably the worst thing you could pull is the companion packs, in my opinion, just because I don't see people buying up book imps and iron golems and shit like that. But other than that, everything else is going to sell, or you can use it easily, you know what I mean? Even the epic variations of those mounts, you can put on yourself and be satisfied with them. But other than that, yeah, I mean, let me know down in the comments if you guys are going to open this personally, or if I missed anything about this lockbox in this video, just drop a comment down below, leaving a tip or anything like that. But other than that, it's been your boy Sunny here, guys, and as always, I would...